Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So in this video, it's a little bit different video because I am having a staycation at the Marina Bay Sands hotel. So let me quickly do a room tour for this Marina Bay Sands hotel. So it's my first time staying here and the room is amazing. Look at the toilet, it's very big. It has a bathtub and here is a place, is a drawer to place your things, and that is a safety box. And in behind the door, we also have a hanging, so you will see you can hang your clothes, or that is the door, by the way. So when you come in, you will see a toilet. And here it is the room. The paintings in the room, I can say it's quite nice. This is the coffee machines. So during the pandemic period, they give a free in the room bar, and also a coffee machines. So this is the couch. It's quite a big couch, and that is the balcony. So we are having a small balcony that we can see the garden by the base view. So in the opposite is the river views, and this is the garden by the base. You see the small gardens, the famous garden by the bay. Okay, so let's go back to the room. Then we can see a nice table, and then we also having a nice lamps. So I would say that the size of the room is quite big, but the TV, maybe because it's 10 years ago, it's not the latest TV and it's not too big either. This is my first staycation ever in Singapore. So you see, this is quite big king bed. Okay, so let me show you outside for the view. You are having the two dome, the garden, flower gardens, and cloud. The other one, I forgot the name, so sorry. That, and this is the, is it the sea? Maybe it's the, yeah. So, and that is the famous garden by the bay, which they have bridge, and then you can pay to just walk to the bridge. The weather is quite nice on the day during my staycations, and you can see a lot of ships there. Okay, that is my friends. And then because it's quite sleepy afternoon, so let's try to make the Nespresso from the coffee machine, Nespresso. Okay, so while waiting for my coffee to be done, I talk about how is the safety or security for people who are going for staycation. Actually, there are now more many checking, so you need to check in and check out every time you enter the tower. So MBS has three towers, so every time you come out from the lift, usually you can just walk away, but now they are asking you to check in, check out for the people who stay. Then you can have visitors, but the maximum visitors you can have is only 5 persons, and by 10 p.m. all the visitors must go back home, must go back. Okay, so let me quickly show you how the view in the garden by the bay and the dome. When it's almost evening, it's like late afternoon, you see all the lights is turning on. And during the time I'm doing the staycation, it's a moonlight festival. Not moonlight, it's a, so it's like a mid-autumn festival, which is for Chinese. They are celebrating with family reunion, looking out for the moon because it's the brightest and the roundest moon of the month. And we usually eat mooncake, so I really love the mooncake, that's why I like moon festival. Okay, so showing you the corridor of the Marina Bay Sands. Actually, surprisingly, many people go for staycation, and when we check in, it took like 1 hour to check in. Maybe this one understandable because people has been staying at home from early March until now. So when they are opening hotels to let people do staycation, they are just quickly enjoying and book a hotel to stay, and also maybe to support the economy. Okay, so Marina Bay Sands have connected with the casino and shopping mall. So I feel this is quite good because then I can go down to eat and or to shop. And Marina Bay Sands, the shop is a luxury. So they have a lot of Chanel, Gucci. Yeah, so this is just showing you a quick look at the shops at MBS. And if for those of you who are not staying in Singapore, maybe when we open the border, you can consider to visit. And this is the new illuminating. Before the pandemic, they let kids or adults to go inside to just play or enjoy the beautiful lights. But because we are having a social distancing, so nobody is allowed to go inside. So see the beautiful lights. It's quite relaxful and quite entertaining for me after staying at home for quite a few months, and we also working from home until now. Okay, so I decided to go back to the hotel because I walk enough, and then I shop, not really shopping, but just do window shopping. It's enough. So, and the shopping mall and the hotel is connected. So the thing is, when you go out from the shopping mall or you go inside the hotel, you need to do another check-in and check-out, which is understandable because we want everyone to be safe. So this is the hotel lobby. It's surprisingly quite crowded. It means hopefully the economy will come back soon. And look at this nice lobby. And actually in Marina Bay Sands and the shops, they have many good Michelin star or famous chef restaurant, which is they have one in each of the tower. And the one that in my tower is the C'est La Vie. Maybe next time I will try that. It's not cheap, and this is one of the fine Chinese cuisine restaurant. Yeah, so it's good to be outside and to feel like a holiday because you are staying in a hotel, although you are still in Singapore. Okay, and then the one thing that everyone is look forward to when they are staycation at the Marina Bay Sands is the swimming pool. So Marina Bay Sands is known to have a beautiful swimming pool, and because of pandemic, I think it's bring a good or and bad thing. Good things is they will limit the numbers of people who can swim, so we can't just walk in to swim. We need to book a appointment, and that is the bad thing. Good things is then we have less people. So it's only few people can go for one session, which is 1 hour. And I got to try how to swim in 11 p.m. night. And you can see from the water, the wind actually quite strong. But this one doesn't make us stop from swimming. You see a lot of people still go swim, midnight swim. So 1 hour session, meaning is from 11 p.m. to 12 midnight. This is the first time for me to have this beautiful view from the swimming pool. You see the tree, wind is so strong, but people still hang around here. I really quite enjoy the experience. And finally, I can say that I tried to swim in this pool before. I also book the next day for morning. So I will show you guys the different view of the pool nights and morning. Okay, so the swimming pool is in the level 57. So finally, we finished the midnight swim, and it's 12 midnight now. And the lifeguard is actually quite good. So they're asking people to go out after the sessions, and then maybe mine is the last session already. Okay, so it's very nice that after swim, you just wear your robe and then you go back to your room and then go showers. So, and maybe after swimming, we will feel so energized and cannot sleep. But yeah, I before the pandemic, right, I always think that staycation is not necessary, but now I feel this is good to have a break. So this is the next day. I book the session for 11 in the morning. So yesterday is midnight and today is the mid afternoon, so the sun is really going strong. Then after I swim for 1 hour, I have a sunburn. It's quite bad sunburns and my skin is peeling after 3 days, but it's okay because I enjoy the experience. And then you see, usually my friends say that before the pandemic, this swimming pool will be full of people, you can't even take any picture. But for me, this is good because they split the swimming pool into three parts, so you can swim only on your chosen parts, but it will have less people. So take a look at the swimming pool, which is can have a great view, and look at the clouds. See, this is a amazing view that I can see now, and I feel blessed that I have this opportunity to stay here. Okay, so the session ended in 1 hour, so everyone is asked to go out because the next session will come, and then they clean up the place quite quick, and everyone need to wear masks. So I'm showing you guys one more look of the swimming pool, the famous swimming pool at Marina Bay Sands, and see, because we are in level 57, see how low the clouds is. And I think it's almost raining, it's cloudy at that day, and it's covered the blue sky. Okay, so let me show you guys a $1 million view. So I dare myself to bring the handphone and take a look at this amazing view downs. Okay, so the left hand side is all the office building where the CBD was, and then we have Esplanade, and then there's the floating platform for NDP. And actually most of the people here, they are not really swimming, so they're just enjoying the views. And it's almost cloudy, but you see behind the cloud is a very beautiful blue sky. So, and you feel like the cloud is so near to you. And once again, the whole view of the infinity swimming pool from level 47. Okay, and so next, bringing you guys to see Garden by the Bay. So during the staycation, we are in the mid-autumn festival mood. So Garden by the Bay is dressed up with all the lantern. Then this is the garden before the entrance of the flower dome. And you see literally nobody here. It used to be full of tourists or local tourists who enjoying a walk through the garden. But it's quite sad to see how the Garden by the Bay looks like now. But this is a lot better than the 2 months of circuit breakers, which is literally nobody. Okay, so this is the Arowana aquarium, and this is the famous tree. And it's still nobody around. And maybe because it's afternoon, so maybe people are still working from home or schooling, or no tourists can come inside. So yeah, it's expected. And actually it's feel good to be walking with less people here. Hopefully next year everything will be better and we can travel again, so the Garden by the Bay won't be so empty. Okay, so let's walk back to the hotel because we have a quite long walk in to Garden by the Bay and buy some snacks to eat. Okay, so guys, that's all the video for today. So enjoy the view for the next in the video. Bye and take care. I met you in the dark. You lit me up. You made me feel as though I wasn't enough.
We danced the night away. We drank too much. I held your hair back when you were throwing up. Then you smiled over your shoulder. For a minute I was stone cold sober. I pulled you closer to my chest, and you asked me to stay over. I said I already told you. I think that you should get some rest. I knew I loved you then, but you'd never know it. 'Cause I played it cool when I was scared of letting go. I knew I needed you, but I never showed it. But I wanna stay with you until we're growing old. Just say you won't let go. Just say you won't let go. I'll wake you up with some breakfast in bed. I'll bring you coffee with a kiss on your head. I'll take the kids to school, wave them goodbye, and I'll thank my lucky stars for that night. When you looked over your shoulder, for a minute I'll forget that I'm older. I wanna dance with you right now. And you look as beautiful as ever, and I swear that every day you'll get better. You make me feel this way somehow. I'm so in love with you, and I hope you know it. Darling, your love is more than worth its weight in gold. We've come so far, my dear. Look how we've grown. And I wanna stay with you until we're great old. Just say you won't let go. Just say. Ghost, 'cause you were always there for me when I needed you most. I'm gone.